Welcome to all of you. In this video, let's revisit rational numbers and their decimal expansion of chapter real numbers in session 4. Okay, rational numbers and their decimal expansions. We have studied the rational numbers in our class 9th. Now let's consider the rational numbers which are terminating. Okay, some of the rational numbers which are terminating. For example, 0.375. If I take I can express it in the form of P by Q. If I express it, it is 375 by 100. Now further, if I simplify both these, it's not 100, 1000. Now, if we further simplify this, then it will be like 375 divided by 10 raised to 3. Further, if you do the simplification of it, it will be 3 by 2 raised to V2 raised to 3. Right? Now, if you consider, this is 1 plus 1. Second example, if you take any other number like, it is 0.104. This is also a rational number which is terminating. So, it is 104 divided by 1000. Right? That is 104 by 10 raised to 3. Simplify this. Take the rational common factors between this and simplify. Then you are getting it as like 13 by 5 raised to 3. Okay, then you consider another number whose decimal expansion terminates like 0.0875. Now it will be 875 by 10 raised to 4. Right, now its simplification if you do, it is 7 divided by 2 raised to 4 into 5. Okay, now these are 3 by 2 raised to 3. All these are the simplified forms of these numbers. When you look at this, what is the pattern do we get? See, all these are the rational numbers whose decimal expansions are terminating. There are rational numbers whose decimal expansions do not terminate and they go on repeating. So, we are only focusing on those rational numbers which are having their decimal expansion terminated. Now, when we are looking at such numbers, you are getting certain patterns. See, what is the pattern? Here, the denominator of each of them is either of 2, 5 or both. That is, the prime factorization in these, or I can say the denominator will have only the factors 2, 5 or both of them. Apart from it, there are no other factors in this denominator. Then, such rational numbers will be terminating. Why? What I mean to say is, suppose they have given you a number like 3 by 8. Then they will ask you to find out whether it is terminating or not. So what we used to do is 3 is divided by 8. Then you will do the division and find whether it is terminating or not. This is not required now. Actual division is not required. Now we will just focus on the denominator. Okay, denominator. Then we will do the prime factorization of this. We will find out the prime factors of this denominator. It is 3 here, numerator 3. Then it is 2 raised to 3 is 8. Now, if any simplification is possible, simplify it and reduce the given number into the simplest form. After that, you check the denominator. In this denominator, if you have only 2 as the factor, or only 5 as the factor, or both the 2 and 5 as the factor. Apart from this, there should not be any other numbers as their factors. If you are getting that, then you can surely say that this number is terminating. It has terminating decimal expansion. Okay, clear. We need not do the actual division at all. So, when they are giving you like this 3 by 2 raised to 8, then this is terminating. Its decimal expansion is 0.378. Now, if it is, they have given you 13 by 5 cube. 5 cube is 125. 5 cube is 125. Now, they will ask you whether 13 divided by 125, is it a terminating rational number or non-terminating repeating rational number? Then, what you will do? We will not do the entire division. We will just check this number in the denominator. We will find out the prime factors of this. With that, we will find first thing we will simplify this fraction then at the simplest form. Now it is 13 by 5 raised to 3. Now I will look at the denominator. The denominator is having only 2 or 5 or 2 and 5 as their factors, then it is terminating. In this case it is having only 5 raised to 3, that means it is having only 5 as its factor. Therefore 13 by 125 is a terminating rational number. Now this result only they have expressed in the form of theorem, that is formal results they have given to you. What actually it is, if x is a rational number and if it can be expressed in the form of p by q, and this q has only 2 as its factor or 5 as its factor or 2 and 5 only as their factor, then that x is terminating rational number. The converse of it, what it says, that is the first theorem they have said, and the converse of it is what, if you have a number in which the denominator has the factor only 2 or 5 or 2 and 5, then that particular rational number is terminating. Okay, that is the converse of each other. Now the question now arises, now if apart from these two, if there are any other numbers in the denominator, then what about that decimal expansion? Then it is natural that it will not be terminating. Then what it is, rational numbers are having only two types of decimal expansion. One is it should be terminating and it is not repeating. Now second type it should be, it is terminating and terminating and it is repeating. So here what I have said is it is terminating. This is one type. That terminating is possible only when the denominators are of the factors either 2, 5 or both. If it is there are some other numbers, then naturally that rational number has a decimal expansion which is non-terminating and repeating. Is it clear? Non-terminating and repeating. So the results which we have learned stated are in this form, page number 16 of your textbook, you see theorem 1.5. What it says, let x be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates. If x be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates, then x can be expressed in the form of p by q. X can be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are co-primes. That is very important. P and q are co-primes. P and q are co-primes, and their prime factorization of q, prime factorization of q is of the form 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m. 5 raised to m, where n and m are non-negative integers. N and m are non-negative integers. Non-negative integers, that means those are positive numbers, non-negative integers. This is your theorem 1.5. Okay, what it says, that x be a rational number, if the decimal expansion of x terminates, then it can be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are co-primes and q factors of q are in the form of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m, where n and m are non-negative integers. This is the result. The next theorem 1.6. What does it say? Converse of this 1.5. Let x be in the form of p by q. X be equal to p by q, be a rational number. This is a rational number such that its prime factorization, that is the prime factorization of q, is of the form 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m. Then same condition, that is n and m are non-negative integers, then what happens? Then x has the decimal expansion which terminates. Okay, is it clear? Did you get the difference? First theorem, in theorem 1.5, what they have said is that you take a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates, then that rational number can be expressed in the form of p by q when the prime factors of q are only 2 raised to n and 5 raised to m. In this theorem 6.1, in theorem 1.6, what they state that let x be a rational number in the form p by q, then the decimal expansion of it will terminate when the factors or the prime factors of q are in the form 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m. Okay, then where n and m are non-negative integers. Then if it is not of both the types, then what will happen? Then it is in page number 17, theorem 1.6, what they say that let x be equal to p by q, a rational number, such that the prime factorization of q, x is of the form p by q, where the prime factorization of q is not of the form 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m. It is not of that form. Then x has decimal expansion. This x has decimal expansion, which is non-terminating recurring. Or you can say repeating. Okay, these three theorems are very important to check whether the given rational number is terminating or not. Okay, clear? So with this we will move to solving the problems of exercise 1.4. Okay, just look at the problems. First question, without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Okay, so with those results, those theorems are important here. In that first question, first bit of that, what they have said, question is 13 by 3125. You have to say whether this is terminating or not. So what you have to do, first you focus on the write the prime factorization of this denominator 3125. The prime factorization of that will be 5 raised to 5. Right now, so it is the this denominator is only containing 5 as its factors. So whether is it terminating or not? It is terminating. Clear? Like that. Then if you see the second one they have given 17 by 8, 17 divided by 2 cube. Now it is in the simplest form where p and q are co-primes, therefore it is also terminating. It is because it is having only 2 has its prime factors in the denominator. Then if you look at the next one they have said 64 divided by prime factorization of this 455, you take up it is 5 into 7 into 13. If you look at any simplification possible, no. Okay, then see, it is having 5 but it is having 7 and 13 as its prime factors. So this number is non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Clear? Like that only. The remaining questions also you try it out. That is the completion of first question. Now moving to the next one, second one, what they have said, write down the decimal expansions of those rational numbers in question 1 or which have the terminating decimal expansions. So in question 1, this, there may be many, only first 2 I have tried it. So these 2 are the terminating rational numbers. Now you have to write down the decimal expansion of them. Like see, 13 by 3125 is there. This is question number 2. Okay. Now how to write the decimal expansion of this? Now should we divide the 13 divided by 3125? Then what is the use of we knowing the result, right? So need not divide it. What we will do, 13, 5 raised to 5 is there. Decimal expansion, you can write it easily when you focus on the denominator. If you make the denominator as multiples of 10, then it will be easy for us to write the decimal expansion. So I will write it as here 2 raised to 5 I will multiply it with, and this also 2 raised to 5 I will multiply, right? So there is no change in the number. So this becomes 13 into 32 divided by 2 into 5, 10, 10 raised to 5, right? So 13 into 35, this you multiply, 13 into 32 divided by 1 followed by 5 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now 13 into 32, how much it will be, you just check that, it is around maybe 416 divided by 1000, how many, 5 zeros, right? Now it is easy to write the decimal expansion. What it will be? 1, 2, 3, 5 zeros are there. 0.00416. Got it? Similarly, this one also. It is what? 17 is there. 17 divided by 2 raised to 3 is there. So, I will make it multiple of 10 by multiplying it by 5 raised to 3, and here also 5 raised to 3 we will multiply and see. Then if you are multiplying it by that, what you are getting here, 17 into 125 divided by 10 raised to 3, right? 17 into 125, 2125 divided by 10 raised to 3, that is 10, 1 followed by 3 zeros. So that how much you are getting, it is 2.12. Clear? This is how you can complete the second mail, other questions. Okay? Moving to the next question, third question. What they have said? The following real numbers have decimal expansions as given below. In each case, decide whether they are rational or not. If they are rational and of the form P by Q, what can you say about the prime factors of Q, they have said. So in that first question, first you have to say whether it is rational or not. If they are, then what type of decimal expansion, and then you have to focus on this Q, that is the prime factors of Q. So 43.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, is it a rational number? Yes, it is a rational number. The decimal expansion of it is terminating. Rational number and decimal expansion is terminating. Then, what they have said now? Now, can we write it in the form of P by Q? Now, this number can be written as 43. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, whole divided by 10 raised to 9. Correct? Right. Then, what it will be now? So, it is written in the form of P by Q. Now, what they have said, if it is in the form of P by Q, what can you say about the prime factors of Q? Now, look at this. 4, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then this 10 raised to 9 can be written as 2 raised to 9 into 5 raised to 9. So, the prime factors of Q are of the form 2 raised to m into 5 raised to n. Okay? So, this is the first one. That is, given this number, it is a rational number. It can be expressed, it is a rational number. It can be expressed in the form of P by Q. And we have expressed it also. And then after expressing, they have asked you to find the prime factors of Q. So, you will write the prime factors of Q are 2 raised to 9 and 5 raised to 9. That is, 2 and 5 are the prime factors of Q. Okay. Then, moving on to the next question. Second question. What they have said, it is 0.1201200012 goes on like this, right? Now, is it a rational number? It is non-terminating, and it is not repeating also. So it is not a rational not a rational number. So once it is not a rational number, no need of it. We cannot put it in the form of p by q. So that there. Look at the third one. Third question. This 43.12345678 9 whole bar. This. Is it a rational number? Yes, it is terminating. It can be expressed in the form of p by q. It is a rational number. And what is the decimal expansion of it? It is terminating. Sorry, it is what? Non-terminating. Non-terminating and repeating, or you can say recurring. Now you have to, if it is non-terminating and recurring and it is a rational number, then you have to put it in the form of p by q. Okay, so let's put it in the form of p by q. So let x be equal to 43.12345678 9. It repeats, correct? No, bar is there. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 continues like this, right? So since the bar is on all the 9 numbers, you are multiplying both the sides by 10 raised to 9. So when you are multiplying, you will get 10 raised to 9x minus this entire thing multiplying by 10 raised to 9. That is 10 raised to 9 is equal to 43 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 continues. Correct. Then this is your first one, first equation. Yeah, this is the second equation. Equation 2 minus equation 1. Then what you are going to get? Here it is 10 raised to 9x minus x is equal to 43 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 continue. Minus, I am writing it here, minus 43.12345678 9 continue. So if you are subtracting it, this entire thing, it gets cancelled. 0.0000, it gets cancelled. Now here it is 6, then this is 4 7 6 5 4 3 2 1 3 4 is equal to 10 raised to 9x minus x. If you are doing, then you are getting 9 times 9 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 x, right? Therefore x is equal to this thing 4 3 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 4 6 by 1 2 3 4 5 6 times 9 7 8 9 times. Okay, it is in the form of, now we have expressed in the form of p by q. Now you have to show, right? Till here it is right. Then next step, what they have said, that you have to show what are the prime factors of this q. So if you simplify this entire thing by 9 table, if you are doing it. Now it is 9 times 1, 9 table means here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? Then on this top you get 4, 7, 9, 1, 4, 9, 5, 1, 9, 4. If you simplify it rightly. Okay? Now still focus on the denominator. It is 4, 7, 9, 1, 4, 9, 5, 1, 9, 4. Now, prime factorization of this, if we do that, you will get 3 square into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. With this prime factorization of this, that shows that q is not of the form 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m. That is why this is not terminating and it is repeating. This is, therefore, x is of this form. Clear? By this, we will come to the end of this exercise 1.4.